Hello and greetings to the first of, I don't know how many of these I'm going to do, but you know, today it's the start of spring break here, and I just felt like doing something different, something that I haven't done before, right? Sun's out, weather's nice, and there's still so much of this place that I've called home in the last 4 years I've never been to. So I just thought it's a good idea with how good the bus network I think is here in Pittsburgh. It's time for a little bit of an adventure where I'm just gonna get on some buses. We're gonna go somewhere and we'll see where it takes us. It's gonna be someplace, a neighborhood, an area of the city, just something new, because I think that's what I'm looking for. So we'll see where we go today. Well, thank you 71A for dropping me out here in, I think we're in Highland Park. I did see on the map that just ahead there is Giant Park or Reservoir. So I think we're gonna be headed there first, check out the place. But looks like your typical Pittsburgh neighborhood out here. Very calm and peaceful. There's a roundabout right there you could actually see. The bus was trying to get over it. And the bus is so big that it ran over the tiny little circle in the middle. You can see that these streets really, I guess, aren't designed for huge vehicles like that out here. I think we made it to the park entrance here. One bus stop. Very picturesque right now. Lots of people around as well. Just important as your president. Swagger so impressive. And I don't need a necklace, but these bitches get impressed when you pull up in that seven. Them sixes, them beanses, I gets the freshies. Rap Simmons, Rick Owens, usually what I'm dressed in. Blowing blunts, rolling doobies up, smoking section. Groupies rush, ole boobies up in my direction. Quit with all the front and you ain't run my click for nothing. Cause our presence is a present, just to kick it is a blessing. Unfortunately, the fountain looks dry, even though we are still in winter here, but snow isn't rain, and I bet it is, can be expensive to maintain these kinds of things. It does look a bit dirty. What can you do? Public parks, you know? Nice place to walk around. There is an outlook right at the edge. Let's go there for a bit. This reminds me a little bit of home. There was a reservoir that my friends and I visited once. Basically, after we graduated high school. And it was basically for a day trip. And I don't know what we were doing. We were just kind of exploring, right? We happened upon this giant reservoir lake. We had some lunch there. Just sat around in the park. Caught up on stuff. Because actually, I don't think it was right after graduation. I think it was after we'd been away for a while at college, and then we came back. And it was so peaceful. Just like it is here. One thing I always wondered is, when they say things like no dogs, do cats count? Is this some kind of animal discrimination out here? At the other edge of the reservoir, not a scenic outlook, I guess you could say, of the city. You can't really see much. Trees are blocking it. Hi, Shadow Me. Hi. I want to try and get to the riverside. It seems like the only proper path would make us have to go around that road all the way over the hill down there. So why waste all that effort? You can just cut through the woods here. What stupid me 2 minutes ago didn't know is that there's only a path that goes right up to where I was. Just had to literally walk 1 minute to the left and I would have seen it. So worth it. I don't know. It's funny because I think I'm gonna have to do the same thing to get down to the parking lot anyway. And then there's another road. Huh. I don't know if we can actually do that to get all the way down. Which is just a tad. Unfortunate. I was wondering this whole time, I was walking down the road, and there's private property over here to the right, and what this place is. I think this is a water park. Some kind of amusement thing out here. Maybe we should go check it out. What a sad day. New cavity. I think this is a conservatory or a zoo. That's what it seems like, at least. We'll see as there is a crosswalk right there. Saw some people inside, which means maybe it's currently open. Hopefully it doesn't cost money though. My questions were answered. This is where the zoo is. I didn't even know. There are definitely kids in there. Alright. Well, I really don't know where I am anymore. What buses these things go to, so That's part of the fun, is it not? Pittsburgh Zoo. There are places all along the fence to the zoo there where I really felt like hopping. I'm trying to sneak in, but you know, wouldn't look good to be arrested the day before I gotta leave, you know? Miss my flight? What a waste of hundreds of dollars. You can't be doing that. Seems like we're getting closer to civilization again. There is a bus there. I wonder which line it is. And the river is just across the road as well. I really gotta pee though. Oh my God. Found this place, hoping my prayers would be answered. Oh, there we go. So there was a bus stop back there, but apparently the tracker says next bus is in 37 minutes. 37 minutes, man. We're just gonna walk along the bus path here and explore what this part of the city has to offer, as this seems to be the only bus line in town here. Numero 75. No parking. What a view though, having the river right in your backyard. Look at this guy. Got that shiny baby. And then old Mater right next door. Motherfucking score. Look at that. There's two buses here instead of one. Okay. Double my chances of getting out of here. And again, what a beautiful view. I wonder if any buses go like all the way up there. Probably not. Huh. Alright. I guess now's a good a time as any to talk about just some general things, you know? Because I don't think this series is meant to just be me walking around commenting on random things. In a way, it's for me to also just talk about how my life's going, just the general state of things, let you guys know how I'm doing out here right now as the cars pass me by. So hello, welcome to my channel, welcome to this video. If you stayed this long to hear this part, kudos to you. You've lasted longer than I've expected. We're out here right now in the middle of, I think this is still Highland Park in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, as we wait for a bus to come pick us up out of this part of the city. And no, this semester has been just a whirlwind. This time in my life, I thought after last semester, things figured out. I thought I had my life sorted. I thought I had my future plans all neatly arranged. There was no entropy. There was no chaos to look forward to disrupt what was going to happen in the future. But that's a lie, because when you least expect it, that's when these kinds of things happen. And the source of the chaos that's kind of been thrown into my life this semester, well, you know, comes from the closest of sources. So, yeah. I was in a relationship for a long while. Now it's over. I don't know, it's hard to really just pick up where you left off 3 years and 3 months ago. Do you even kind of remember how it was like? What it was like? And how I really even just functioned, you know? But it's been a slow process trying to piece it all together again. You know, the first few weeks right afterwards, it was really tough. And I really, in the weeks following, did some stuff that was really stupid. Some stuff that I regret. Some stuff that I'm sure looking back in even just a few months, maybe just like 3-4 months from now, it'll be either a comedic or a sad thing. Something that I laugh at myself for, or something that I'll pity myself for a while. But I don't know if it's part of like the psychiatrist handbook or something. It's like, I think it's something they people say to look out for in case people are gonna like commit suicide or anything, which don't worry, I'm not gonna commit suicide. It's not nearly that bad. There's been way worse moments before. But I think something that people say to look out for is large life changes that people make. Impulsive decisions, you could say. Just things that normally before whatever happened and they've become a different person. Normally they wouldn't do those kinds of things. And now they've made some large life changes that really can worry people, because it's just not what people are used to, the people around them. I've been wondering, have I been doing that? And even if I've been doing that, is that necessarily a bad thing? Because maybe this is the right time to be making some large life adjustment. Life is often about chapters, right? You have one chapter of your life where you're with someone, you're at some place, you're doing something for a period of time. And in a way, you get lulled into a routine, something that is just familiar, something that perhaps even brings you into a state of complacency. And it takes these events, these really quite life-altering events, things that really shake it up, to perhaps actually take you out and cause you to do some life changes, and maybe for the better. Because I think I've had time to think a lot more about who I am, what I want to do, how I should be among my friends, what kind of friend, what kind of family member, what kind of person I want to be for the people around me. Things that I've neglected before, things that I never really thought of, because really, I was complacent. I wasn't thinking much about how I was affecting other people, how things I was doing really were not for the better. And I guess these kinds of events just give you the opportunity to do some reflection now that you have the time for it. Because one chapter of your life is closing, and another one's going to begin. And it's up to me now, as that chapter begins, to make the most of it. To learn from the previous mistakes that I've done, and try and be a better person for the people around me, for myself, and for the people that I will know in the future. I love the brick buildings out here. And it is so peaceful. Kind of have a contrast between the older style, and then clearly a little bit of the new here. Thank you. Not every day you see an orange car. I've always wondered, how hard is it to have a business, open a shop in like these kinds of residential areas? Like, where the hell are people supposed to park? Hope they're doing well. Yo, bitch, she said I'm hot. Man, I told her I agree. She gon' really think I'm hot if I told her my degrees. Pull up in that hard top, showing off my keys. Graduate school of hard knocks. I could show you my degrees. Couple ABCs. Bad bitch, double Ds. Poppin' E, I don't give a F. Told you I'm a G, A-S-A-P. Stevie got it on his sleeve, but I got it on my chest. My nigga, this is what I breathe. Inhale, exhale, coke. I had to do a double take because this doesn't sound right. Street cleaning, no parking in this block, second Wednesday of each month. Okay, that makes sense. I mean, nothing wrong with that. And then you walk across the street here, we're in the same block. No parking. Second Thursday of each month. They really try to take away two of our days? It's gotta be
the loneliest spin scooter. Where are your friends, bro? I don't know if anybody's ever gonna pick this guy up. Corner of Hampton and Jancy. Come save this fellow. So mommy show me how that neck feel. Lady show me how to rest feel. For now just chill.
Thank you.